Hi dear students, this is Mr. Sanjay Kumar. Chaura English Medium School once again welcomes you all for learning 7th standard history subject. Dear students, today we are going to learn the remaining part of lesson number 10, the expansion of the Maratha power. Here in the first part of this lesson, we have studied the different points. Now, let's revise what did we learn in the first part of this lesson. So, let's begin its introduction. Dear students, the first point which we have studied in the first part of this lesson, that is the release of Shahu Maharaj. Here we know that Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj was under the captivity of Prince Ajam Shah. Prince Ajam Shah thought that if he would release Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj from his captivity, then there would be a struggle, a conflict in between Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj and Maharani Tarabai for the throne of the Maratha Empire. He further thought that this conflict in between Maharani Tarabai and Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj would make the Maratha power weak. That's why Prince Ajam Shah released Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj from his captivity. After getting released from the captivity of Prince Ajam Shah, Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj came to Maharashtra. In Maharashtra, he met different Maratha Sardars. He organized different Maratha Sardars, and with the help of them, he claimed that he would be the next Chhatrapati for the Maratha Empire. But this claim of Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj was not accepted by Maharani Tarabai. So there was a battle in between the armies of Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj and the army of Maharani Tarabai. They fought each other, and in this battle Maharani Tarabai was defeated. After defeating Maharani Tarabai, Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj captured the Satara region and he coronated himself. On the other hand, Maharani Tarabai also proclaimed that
her son
Shivaji II would be the Chhatrapati for the Panhala region, for the Kolhapur region. And in this way, the two different independent Maratha kingdoms were
arisen
in India. Dear students, the next point which we have studied in the first part of the lesson was the information about Balaji Vishwanath. After coming towards Maharashtra, Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj appointed Balaji Vishwanath as a Peshwa. Balaji Vishwanath was the great general. He convinced many Maratha Sardars that Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj was the real heir for the Maratha kingdom. Not only this, Balaji Vishwanath also obtained the right to collect Chauthai and Sardeshmukhi from the Mughal territory in Deccan region. In this way, dear students, we have studied all these points in detail. Now, dear students, let us get information about Bajirao first. Bajirao first was the son of Balaji Vishwanath. After the death of Balaji Vishwanath, Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj appointed his son Bajirao first as next Peshwa in 1720. Here, during that time, he expanded the Maratha power. Now, let us try to understand how Bajirao first defeated Nizam at Palkhed. During that time, Farukh Sher was the Mughal emperor. Farukh Sher, the Mughal emperor, appointed Nizam-ul-Mulk as the Subedar of the Deccan region. We know that the Mughal emperor had given the right to collect Chauthai and Sardeshmukhi from the territories of the Mughal empire. Here, Chauthai means the right to collect 1/4 part of the revenue from the territory of the Mughal empire, and Sardeshmukhi means the right to collect 1/10 part of the revenue from the Mughal territory. And in this way, the Marathas were enjoying the right to collect the revenues. But Nizam was against this right. Not only this, Nizam also entered into the Pune Pargana and captured different regions from the Pune Pargana. So, Bajirao first decided to teach him a good lesson. He decided to attack the region where he was living, that is at Palkhed. Here, there was a battle between Bajirao first and the Nizam. In this battle, Nizam was defeated and he was made to accept the right of Marathas to collect Chauthai and Sardeshmukhi. Now, dear students, let us try to understand how Malwa was brought under the control of Marathas. The Marathas started to conquer one after another the different territories from the Mughal Empire. Because during that time, the Mughal Empire was not in strong position. Bajirao first so tried to expand the Maratha power in the northern side. Malwa, in today's Madhya Pradesh state, was the part of the Mughal Empire. Here, Malwa region was under the control of the Mughal emperor. Bajirao wanted to capture it. So he sent Mallarao Holkar, Ranoji Shinde, Udaji Pawar under the leadership of Chimaji Appa. Who was Chimaji Appa? Chimaji Appa was his brother. Under the leadership of his brother Chimaji Appa, he gave the order to conquer Malwa region. These all Maratha people were successful in conquering the Malwa region. they establish their power. Now dear students, it was the turn of Bundelkhand. Bundelkhand means some part of today's Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh. It was the area around Jhansi, Panna and Sagar. Here at this Bundelkhand region, there was the ruler Chhatrasal. It was ruled by Chhatrasal. He had established his own kingdom at Bundelkhand. But Muhammad Khan Bangush, who was the Mughal Subedar at Allahabad, he wanted to capture the Bundelkhand area. That's why he attacked Bundelkhand and defeated Chhatrasal. Here, after the defeat from the Mughal Subedar, King Chhatrasal made an appeal to Bajirao first for his help. So, Bajirao first went to Bundelkhand and he attacked the region which was captured by the Mughal Subedar Muhammad Khan Bangush. He defeated him and at last Bajirao first brought back Bundelkhand region to the King Chhatrasal. That's why Bajirao first was honored by King Chhatrasal. In this way, the Marathas established the power at Malwa as well as Bundelkhand region. Now dear students, let us move on to the next point, the Battle of Bhopal. We know that Malwa was under the control of the Marathas. So, Bajirao first demanded the subedari of the Malwa region. But the Mughal emperor declined his demand. Therefore, Bajirao first marched towards Delhi region in 1737. Here, when the Mughal emperor saw the march of Bajirao first, he was surprised. He felt uncomfortable. So, he requested the Nizam to protect Delhi from Bajirao first. Here, Nizam came with his huge army and therefore there was the huge battle between Bajirao first and Nizam. Once again, here Bajirao first defeated Nizam. Nizam at last agreed to give Malwa Subedari for the Marathas from the emperor. Dear students, we know that India is a rich country. During that time also, the different foreign rulers had an eye on our rich country. Nadir Shah, who was the emperor of Iran, attacked India. He was thinking to steal the valuable things from our country. And that's why he attacked on India, particularly the Mughal territory. So the Mughals took the help of the Marathas. The Mughal emperor was sure about the power and wealth of the Marathas. According to the Mughal emperor, there was no other
powerful ruler
as strong as the Marathas. That's why they took the help of the Marathas for protecting their territory. So Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj sent Bajirao first for defending the Mughal power. Bajirao first set out with his big army for defending the Mughal power. When he reached up to the Burhanpur region, Nader Shah had returned to his country, that is Iran. But before going back to his country, he looted a large number of valuable things from Delhi region. Now dear students, let us move on to the last point, that is the death of Bajirao first. Bajirao first was a great general. He defeated Nizam at Palkhed and Bhopal. He made him to accept the subedari of the different territories. He conquered Malwa as well as Bundelkhand. He made to run away Nadir Shah. In this way, Bajirao first established the Maratha power, the Maratha supremacy in the northern part of our country. He created the formidable power in India. In his time, the Shinde, Holkar, Pawar and Gaikwad families got importance. But at last, such a great general, Bajirao first, breathed his last in April 1740 at Raverkhedi. He died at last at Raverkhedi on the bank of the Narmada River. Dear students, in this way, in this part of the lesson, we have studied the information about how the Maratha power was expanded by Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj and the different Peshwas. Thank you.